My name is Evin Yucel. I'm a clinical instructor at Harvard Medical School and an assistant physician in the heart valve program of Massachusetts General Hospital in Boston, Massachusetts. Today's talk is going to be about indications for treatment of aortic stenosis. Key takeaways of today's talk are reviewing medical therapy for aortic stenosis and reviewing indications for aortic valve replacement. With the advent of transcatheter valve techniques, the value of multidisciplinary valve team and proficiency in treating patients with valve disease has become increasingly apparent. Heart valve centers and heart valve teams allow optimization of patient outcomes through improved decision making and matching of patients to providers with appropriate expertise, experience, and resources. Therefore, the guideline committee recommends patients with severe valve disease to be evaluated by the multidisciplinary valve team. When contemplating the treatment of asymptomatic patients or those who have multiple comorbidities for whom valve intervention is considered, consultation or referral to a comprehensive heart valve center is reasonable. How about medical therapy for aortic stenosis? First and foremost, treatment of hypertension is indicated, being mindful that patients with severe aortic stenosis has fixed obstruction. Secondly, statin therapy is indicated for all patients for primary and secondary prevention of atherosclerotic disease, as concurrent coronary artery disease is very common, reaching about 50% prevalence among patients with severe aortic stenosis. The rationale for including all patients, regardless of their traditional risk assessment, comes from a randomized, double-blinded clinical trial called the simvastatin and ezetimibe in aortic stenosis trial, which was designed to study the effects of long-term intensive cholesterol lowering with daily use of simvastatin and ezetimibe on clinical and echocardiographic outcomes in patients with asymptomatic, mild to moderate aortic valve stenosis, and no other indication for lipid-lowering treatment. In this study, there was good LDL reduction without a significant change in aortic stenosis severity, but there was a 20% reduction in cardiovascular events at follow-up. These events were mostly driven by the need for coronary artery bypass grafting. For patients with aortic stenosis, decision on timing of intervention is the next essential step. Factors that play a role in this decision include presence of symptoms, LV systolic function, and need for undergoing other cardiac surgery. For patients with symptomatic severe high-grade stenosis, aortic valve replacement improves outcomes and therefore carries a class 1 indication. Outcomes are poor with severe low-gradient aortic stenosis, but are still better with aortic valve replacement than with medical therapy. Among patients who are asymptomatic with severe aortic stenosis, when LV ejection fraction is decreased below 50%, whether this is due to aortic stenosis or other causes, the survival is better in patients who undergo aortic valve replacement, and therefore aortic valve replacement is recommended in these patients. Among the asymptomatic patients, exercise stress testing may unmask symptoms or it can lead to abnormal hemodynamic response, which should prompt consideration of surgical aortic valve replacement. Patients have very severe aortic stenosis, BNP levels 3 times above normal, or rapid progression of disease should also be considered for surgical aortic valve replacement. How about patients who have bicuspid aortic valve disease who are undergoing surgical aortic valve replacement and who also have aortopathy? Within the current guidelines, there's really no significant changes, but just to make a note of that, if they are undergoing aortic valve replacement, threshold for replacement of ascending aorta or sinuses is more than or equal to 4.5 centimeters. Thank you for your attention.